Wrestling Reverend Church, and I am by myself on commentary. This is the greatest day ever. This actually will be a DVD to own because of this.
From State College, Pennsylvania, he is the Enigma, Lucio Dummy!
In case you didn't notice, I'm going to preface this now. I'm the only one here. Doc, you were taken out last month because of the circle and what you did to them.
First opponent.
Piv apparently decided to go massage the wounds of Doc, so he's not here tonight. And to start off RWA No Retreat 5, we have a four-way match for the Cruiserweight Championship. Some newcomers, some old faces. And the Hill District from the great city of Calgary, Alberta, Cleveland.
And the third opponent in this match.
Here comes a man with an attitude all his own. Got Sarin here tonight, not a fan here tonight, is happy with Scott Sarin. Scott Sarin has found a very bad attitude, and I kind of like it. And in case you don't know, the roof is about to come off this place because of this music.
Are you working solo?
I am.
I'm sorry.
Coming out to one of the loudest ovations I think I've ever heard here in RWA. Dear God, man. The human tornado that is G-Raver is in the building. And Alexa kisses G-Raver. And apparently tonight, since I was flying solo, I'm going to be joined by the one and only Bert LeGrand.
You know, Dr. Feelbad mentioned something to me in passing. He was in a hurry today, but he mentioned something in passing about not trusting you on your own. Don't know what that's all about. Don't get it. I listen to the DVDs. I watch them. I don't know why, but I'm here with you, Church.
Well, you know what? Sometimes the truth hurts. Most people don't want to hear it, but by the end of the night, everybody will know the truth.
That's why Doc's not here, I guess.
That's why Doc's not here, and that is why I am the voice of RWA.
The voice of RWA, literally in this case for tonight. That's why I'm here keeping you in check. I tell you what, as a fan, in addition to being in the ring announcer, as a fan, I'm looking forward to this match.
This match is going to be off the chart. G-Raver, as we all know, is completely over the top. He will do anything to win, and proof has been what we've seen in his last matches. And here we go. Scott Sarin and G-Raver going head-to-head. Meanwhile, Jay Ice and Deveers going at it. Irish whip reversal.
You're very good at what you do, Church, but you know, I think we are going to need two people to keep up with all the action here tonight.
It is going to be difficult to keep up with that double instigiri, by the way, from Jay Ice and G-Raver. Looking like they are forming an alliance here.
We've seen him go all the way back a long time on different sides of the rail. It's interesting to see him watch him fight together.
This is going to be highly interesting. Jay Ice and G-Raver egging each other on. Watch out, Jay Ice over the top. Taking out Scott Sarin and Deveers.
His body, unreal by Jay Ice, unreal.
That is why, despite the crowd reaction Jay Ice is getting, he is a friend of mine. He is athletic. He knows what he is doing in that ring. And wait a minute, what do we got going on here?
They're clearing the aisle. Security is clearing the chairs.
Oh, and there we have our first plate of chops served here tonight in RWA.
Unbelievable. And speaking of two guys who go all the way back, G-Raver and Scott Sarin, they know each other very well. They've been tag team partners, they've been opponents, and it's like watching two old friends and two old enemies.
Two count only on Scott Sarin by G-Raver. As you were saying, Bert, I agree. Scott Sarin and G-Raver have gone toe-to-toe, nose-to-nose, and against everybody else here in RWA, basically, at one point as a tag team. They know each other inside and out, but yet, G-Raver, two count, by the way, G-Raver still only ever seems to get these short victories, the ones that don't count against Scott Sarin.
And I was listening to you, but you know what? I was interrupted by the slam in this case, the nickname means everything. Lucio Deveers. Lucio Deveers, the enigma. He is the enigma as far as RWA fans go in this match. They know Sarin, they know G-Raver, they know Jay Ice. Lucio Deveers is truly, literally the unknown commodity in this match. It's interesting to see how he does.
It will be interesting to see how this newcomer here in RWA fares against a seasoned veteran like Jay Ice.
The one thing he is doing is shrinking. When he came out to the ring, he was 7 foot tall with his hairdo. Now it's down a little bit. Now I'd say it's down to about 6'1".
That's about a good estimate, I would say. Jay Ice going for a DDT on the ring apron reversal by Deveers. Suplex on the side of the ring apron. Double suplex on the side of the ring apron. Deveers takes out Jay Ice. Scott Sarin takes out G-Raver. Two men are down, two men are in. What kind of chaos are we going to see from this match still?
Sorry, Church. Dr. Fieldbad was in my ear making sure you're up to your standards. I assured him you were.
I'm always up to standard.
Indeed, always you are, my friend. Always you are. And G-Raver looking a little worse for wear against Lucio Deveers.
G-Raver and now Deveers going at it. Irish whip reversal, and what a clothesline by Deveers, knocking down G-Raver. Taking him down, going for the cover. One, two, and no. Two count only by Deveers.
By appearances, you can tell that Deveers, they're roughly all the same size. Deveers is a little bit of a stockier quality, so he's got a little more of the strength department, which is a real asset in the high-flying cruiserweight division. To be the one with strength, that's a real ace up your sleeve.
Absolutely it is, but I can tell you one thing, what I've seen in the past, strength does not matter when it comes to speed, especially the speed of a G-Raver or a Jay Ice.
True.
Chaos ensuing in this match.
I can't keep it all up. This is the best seat in the house us commentators have, but you know, it's even tough to keep up all the action. Right here in front of us, Jay Ice and Scott Sarin are going at it, toe-to-toe, hammer and nail.
Jay Ice shoving a mustard-covered napkin in Scott Sarin's mouth. Meanwhile, Deveers with a two count only on G-Raver in the ring.
Impossible to follow the action. Impossible to follow.
This is chaos. Scott Sarin now working over the arm of Jay Ice.
Nice, understandable.
G-Raver in the corner. Deveers, Irish whip reversal. G-Raver. Oh! Drop kick to the back of the head.
That's
of
a high high-flying style we talked about. G-Raver is unquestionably, like him or not, the master at the high-flying style.
G-Raver death-defying in every move that he takes.
5 minutes gone by. 5 minutes.
Jay Ice now in the ring. One, two, and no. Two count only on Jay Ice by Scott Sarin. Scott Sarin slowing things down a little bit in the ring with a reverse chin lock.
And that's what Scott Sarin's done. Maybe it's just change of philosophy over the past few months, but he can still do the high-flying stuff. But he seemed to switch to a more
base. G-Raver on the ring. Looks like he's going to fly. Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's what he does best, giving up his body. I mean, you saw how I can't believe how far he flew. I can't believe it.
He had Deveers sitting in a chair, dropkick off the ring apron into Deveers, taking him basically out of the equation. We almost had a submission in the ring, by the way. You know, this is so hard to call.
Normally it's the best seat in the house where he was positioned, but with G-Raver coming out, you force.
G-Raver with the pin on Deveers. Two count only.
Unbelievable action here.
Sorry to keep cutting you off, Bert. I'm trying to call everything as best I can.
We're trying here.
Dear God, man.
It's two matches at once. It is two matches at once. Literally, that's what this is. I envy Bo Browning, the referee, trying, keyword trying, to keep his tabs on everything here.
Yeah, good luck with that ref. What'd you say his name is?
His name's Bo Browning.
Okay. I'll be sure not to remember that.
There you go. It should be Joe Browning with as much patience as he's displayed with these guys.
Double arm ringer.
Stereo.
One by Scott Sarin on Jay Ice, one on G-Raver by Deveers.
You can definitely tell they did a little bit of strategy. It's every man for himself in this match, to be sure. But you can tell they did a little bit of strategy before this match, did Lucio and Scott Sarin.
Wait a minute. Jay Ice and G-Raver both pulling off the same maneuver, flipping off over the ropes, taking Deveers and Scott Sarin out of the ring, and now a standoff between the two.
And there's the trust and respect factor they have, the trust and respect factor. There's still a little bit of animosity there, very little.
Wait a minute.
What's he doing? What is Jay Ice doing?
Wait a minute.
The fans are scurrying on this side. They're scurrying on this side of the ring.
Jay Ice down on all fours. G-Raver. Flying up and over the top rope.
Unbelievable move by G-Raver.
Out to Veers. Scott Sarin.
Unbelievable move. Unbelievable.
Dear God.
But Jay Ice is a smart man. Jay Ice is a smart man. He was staying in the ring.
Jay Ice was staying in the ring.
He was staying in the ring. He had the advantage.
Off the top rope. Splash taking out everyone.
I know he's your friend. I like him too, but I gotta question the wisdom of that move by Jay Ice. You had your three opponents in a prone position outside that ring, and you gave up your body to go after them when you had pretty much the win in your fingertips.
I agree with you, Bert. Wait a minute, we got a pin. One, two, and no. Two count only on Deveers by G-Raver. I've talked to Jay Ice in the past about maneuvers like that, and I asked him why. He's basically told me it's the heat of the moment. He gets caught up in the adrenaline rush, and he's just got to go for it.
There is no doubt adrenaline is a factor whenever you wrestle anywhere in the RWA or any other company. But in this case, maybe it's tenfold. Maybe it's 15-fold.
Jay Ice taking Scott Sarin down outside the ring. G-Raver.
On G-Raver by Lucio Deveer. And again, that's the enigma factor we talk about. We don't know anything about this guy. We don't know that much about Lucio Deveer, and that's the sort of thing he can pull out any time.
Head and arm suplex by Deveer on G-Raver, tossing him in the corner. Almost had a three count.
He crumpled him like in the corner, and he did.
I'm sure, Bert, if you've heard me say it once, you've heard me say it 1,000 times whenever I do commentary. Almost only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades, and they're not playing either one of those here tonight.
Right now, no time for it in this match. This match is too fast-paced.
Wait a minute.
Oh, my. Oh, God. Lucio going for the suplex.
Wait a minute.
As well, this is insane.
This is, oh my god!
Oh my god!
Jay Ice with a German suplex on Deveers while Deveers had G-Raver in a back suplex.
Take your bets
off the top rope.
Take your bets as to who got the worst of that one. But I think who got the best, maybe Scott Sarin. He wasn't involved in any of that.
Scott Sarin, you're right. He had the best opportunity. Icebreaker by Jay Ice.
10 minutes.
Scott Sarin did have the best ability out of that until Jay Ice hit him with the icebreaker.
Unbelievable maneuver.
Roll through.
That's a strong style we talk about. That's the grounded pound strong style of Jay Ice.
One-legged Boston Crab and a beauty.
Deveers awfully close to the rope, though. He's awfully close. Jay Ice has to get better positioning.
He could be close to the rope, but if he taps, it doesn't matter how close you are to those ropes. And Jay Ice dragging him back.
He must have heard me. G-Raver and Scott Sarin right now, not in much position to stop him, although here comes G-Raver.
G-Raver, wait a minute. G-Raver on the top rope. Swanton! On the back of Deveers, which caused Jay Ice to get kicked out of the ring. Two and three.
That's it. I gotta do my job.
I gotta do your other job. G-Raver, still the Cruiserweight champion. G-Raver with an impressive Swanton bomb off the top rope to the back of Deveers, causing Jay Ice to be kicked off of the one-legged Boston Crab, and outside the ring, G-Raver taking advantage of the situation, getting the three count, and remaining RWA Cruiserweight champion. What a hell of a way to start off RWA's No Retreat 5. I will give it to Jay Ice, as much as I don't like the fact that he did it, showing sportsmanship, shaking the hand of G-Raver. Start off RWA No Retreat 5. I got a pain in the ass telling me it was good.
25 pounds. He hails from Nashville, Tennessee. Here is Billy Brash.
Billy Brash. Newcomer here to RWA from good old Nashville, Tennessee. And you can tell by the mildly retarded look on his face that he is from Nashville, Tennessee. He's already starting with the river dirt here in RWA. I kind of like it. The sound guy had enough of John Bon Jovi, so did I. Oh, Billy's found a friend over there, it looks like. Billy Brash may just be that Brash in showing up in his first appearance here in RWA. This man, however, not a newcomer here to RWA. A powerhouse here in RWA. Undefeated, if memory serves me correctly, here in RWA. Taking on the newcomer, Billy Brash. Billy Brash finding some friends earlier over there. This could be a very interesting match.
I believe it's called Getting to Know the RWA Family.
It's called Getting into a Fight with the River Dirt.
That too, however you want to play it, but this is going to be a very interesting match. We don't know much about Billy Brash, and what we've seen from Brady Pierce so far, you have to admit, it's been very impressive.
Yeah, Brady Pierce has been a virtual steamroller. He is a powerhouse, and if memory serves me, maybe you can help me out with this, Bert. I said earlier that he's undefeated here in RWA.
I believe you are correct about that. I believe you're very correct, and it's moves like that. That would explain why. He is a powerhouse to be sure.
Brady Pierce just tossing Billy Brash out of the ring onto the floor. Billy Clayman pulled the hair by Brady Pierce.
I'm
a fan of the hair pull, don't get me wrong, but I don't think Brady Pierce needs to pull any hair.
I don't think he does to make it prove his point either. You know, you talk to him away from the ring, very humble guy, very, very likable guy, but you get him in that ring, it's almost like the Incredible Hulk. You won't like him when he's angry.
Somebody done pissed in Brady Pierce's Cheerios every time he comes out here.
Apparently,
that's why he's so angry.
He's trying to find the man who did it, and I believe he thinks he's located right across from him in that ring.
Billy Brash once again being tossed down and thrown into the corner. Brady Pierce standing tall in the ring again.
So you have the physical dominance so far, and now I think you have the mental dominance. Now I think you have the mental dominance. You can tell Billy Brash is a little bit off his game right now, and that Brady Pierce is definitely getting in his head.
Oh, Brady Pierce, just by his mere presence, gets in people's heads. But by the fact that him using that power got into Billy Brash a little bit more, hence why the boot to the midsection, off the ropes, drops down, leapfrog. Billy Brash thinks he's smart, not so much. Back elbow, clothesline. Billy Brash down once again, thanks to Brady Pierce. Into the corner, up and down he goes.
Yeah, with two relative newcomers, there's not much of an experience differential. So you gotta rely on pure ability. And right now, Brady Pierce is showing that ability. Billy Brash is trying. He's trying to do what he can. He has to stick and move, so to speak, and he's trying his best, but Brady Pierce is just too much for him.
Billy Brash was calling for a timeout on the floor earlier. Ref said he ain't giving it to him.
I don't think he gets any timeouts in wrestling. I seem to think that's the rule.
It just depends. Billy Brash claiming a pull of the tights now by Brady Pierce. Next thing you're gonna say, Billy Brash is gonna say is Brady Pierce hit him with the kitchen sink.
Maybe he unleashed his shoelaces, who knows?
Wait a minute. The power of Brady Pierce up and over inside the ring from outside, suplex two and no. Brady Pierce only got a two count from that particular move on Billy Brash. Fists back and forth. Brady Pierce, Billy Brash, fighting it out, the old fisticuff style. I like it, but you don't want to go toe-to-toe with a powerhouse.
You don't want to go there, and Billy Brash is looking at the hard way, but he's coming back with a couple shots of his own. He's doing what he needs to do.
Swinging neck breaker by Billy Brash. One count only on Brady Pierce.
You gotta get a lot more offense in on Brady Pierce to weaken him enough where it's even the thought to win the match.
Now, if there's one thing that I have seen in my 4+ years here in RWA, it is this. No matter the power of your opponent, when you're down on the ground, that power doesn't come into play.
Not at all. Not at all.
And that is what Billy Brash is actually working with right now. Nope. Taking Brady Pierce down to the ground, keeping him there.
The term is leveling the playing field. And right now, Billy Brash has planted Brady Pierce on it.
That's exactly it. He is negating the power of Brady Pierce, keeping him tied up. As you can see, he's got the legs wrapped around him as well. Brady Pierce doesn't really have nowhere to go.
Yeah. Now, like we've seen Brady Pierce in this position before, Billy Brash definitely knows what he's doing in terms of the submission area.
We haven't seen him in that position before, but as he showed, he can pull out of it.
He can power out of it. That's what he's got. He may not have the experience to know all the counters and the holds, but he definitely has the power.
Experience comes with time in ring, and Brady Pierce being here every month since his debut, taking on some of the big names here in RWA, he's getting that experience really quickly.
The RWA is definitely a place Brady Pierce likes to go to get that competition.
Swinging neck breaker once again by Billy Brash, up and down with the flying leg drop. One, two, and no, two count only. Hooking the leg this time, still only got a two count.
Good fundamentals. You can definitely see, you know, he's from Nashville, and you definitely see some of the Tennessee tendencies, the brawling, the real rough grinding style definitely coming into play when you watch Billy Brash wrestle.
Oh, absolutely. You've seen that style before from people like the Rock and Roll Express, the Midnight Express.
Anybody, Fantastics, Fabulous Ones, you name it, you see that style in there. And right now, I think he's talked to him a little bit. I think he's talked a little trash on him, trying to get into Brady Pierce's head.
Billy Brash talking trash. And I think it fired him up. I think it fired the man up, actually. If you notice, Billy Brash knocked back into the corner. Brady Pierce just throwing right hands.
Maybe he told to stay down, and we all know Brady Pierce does not like to be told what to do. Blocks the hip toss, comes back with a shot of his own.
Swinging neck breaker a third time. Working over the neck area of Brady Pierce over and over
again. Smart move. When you control the neck, you control the body.
Flying elbow and a beauty.
Oh, hit with precision.
Two count only.
Don't like that cover, though, but the move was excellent. He hit that move with precision, no wasted motion. If only he had a better cover, he probably would have gotten him.
Didn't hook the legs, just tried to get a pin. Now, what's going on here? What's Billy Brash doing?
Referee Jimmy James clearly seeing what Billy Brash has to do.
Billy Brash looks like he's putting on a glove. I've seen this from former Tennessee stars. He was going for the claw. Made famous by Baron von Raschke, of all people. Brady Pierce saw it come and reversed it. And now is just taking control of Billy Brash. Maybe that wasn't the best time to go for that glove.
He thought it was, and quite frankly, he ought to think this is his only shot. Because Brady Pierce, you gotta think, is in total control.
Oh my God!
Oh wow, overhead belly to belly suplex. Unbelievable maneuver. I thought that had him. I'm not gonna lie, Church, I thought that had him.
Billy Brash isn't dead. That's surprising.
That is a miracle. I gotta say, that is a miracle.
Billy Brash back up on his feet after being unceremoniously dumped
dead.
On his head.
He's not dead. He wish he were, but here he's got a little bit of fight left in him.
Got out of the ring, got out of the way in time. Brady Pierce wasn't able to stop, hit the turnbuckle.
Oh.
Move, once again, move.
Oh.
Kick to the face by Billy Brash.
Good dexterity. He's fine with everything he's got left in him. Wow, very good move. He's a little bit.
Cutter. Billy Brash up and over the top rope with a cutter-like maneuver.
An aerial to ground maneuver. Very interesting maneuver by Billy Brash.
Still only a two count on Brady Pierce.
Quite get the job done, but you got a lot of damage on Brady Pierce with that move.
Brady Pierce showing exactly why he is here in RWA. Sit down powerbomb countered. Beautiful maneuver. Two count only. By Brady Pierce.
Thought he had him with the power move. Definitely caught him by surprise with that move, but Billy Brash showed just enough to get out of it.
I think Brady Pierce has had enough. Yep. Here it is, torture rack.
Torture rack time.
Brady Pierce got Billy Brash up in the torture rack.
Nowhere to go.
Billy Brash tapping out, giving up.
Here's your winner.
Let you do it, buddy.
Brady Pierce.
submission win here at RWA No Retreat 5. Once again, proving why he is here in RWA and proving why he is a powerhouse to be reckoned with. Face, and that's just coming out to the ring.
And his opponent.
Oh boy. A very intense feud last month, and it looks like we're going to continue it here again tonight. Zubov, the Russian American. Out here, glad hand and all the river dirt here in West Newton. You might want to take a shower after you've touched these people. Zubov, definitely the fan favorite here in RWA. Between the two of these, William the Hammer Roberts, I have a feeling, is going to use his power, while Zubov is going to use his years of experience. This should be a very interesting contest, considering the continuation of last month's feud, where it basically was a count out.
This is definitely age versus experience. This is definitely smarts versus power, brains versus brawn.
Absolutely. Collar Nova tie-up, and William the Hammer Roberts showing exactly why he is the power here in RWA.
You know, he could very well be the most bell-to-bell intense wrestler I think we have with this entire roster. His intensity is unmatched. What he has to do is channel that intensity properly to get him in the win column a little bit more often.
His intensity starts as soon as he comes out of the entranceway.
You saw me back off.
I don't blame you. I would back off, too.
When he runs the ropes like that, the man is a moving tank.
Zubov moving out of the way, taking down the hammer with the Russian-American sickle. Boot to the midsection, off the rope, Zubov. Swinging neck breaker.
Don't get me wrong, Zubov definitely has a power set of his own. Definitely something he can work on. He can't match William, but he definitely has the experience.
Absolutely. You match the power that Zubov has with the experience, the years and years of experience that Zubov has. That's what makes this a very interesting contest.
Indeed. And definitely Zubov also has the fans on his side. William Roberts is kind of a younger, a young guy, a little inexperienced, but Let's see whether or not he can channel those fans out of his mind as he wrestles against Zubov.
That was experience right there. The hammer suckering in Zubov, taking his neck and draping across that top rope and yanking down on him. Zubov now choking for air. There's one thing experience and power can't give you, and that's the ability to breathe.
That's
if
air.
You can't breathe, you can't wrestle.
You take a man's ability to breathe, you take a man anything, he can't wrestle, he can't do anything, he can't even think.
Choking him on the ropes. The hammer realizes he's got a count of five before it's a disqualification.
Take
breaking on four. The referee can't do anything but count that high.
4 seconds of unabated advantage on Lloyd Hammer Roberts. He's a smart man for his experience level.
Well, I'll be perfectly honest, looking at that referee, I'm surprised he can count to four.
Oh, see, you don't need to go there. Our referees are properly trained, highly competent in what they do.
You've seen the referees we've had here in the past. Oh, they don't know anything.
I've seen the referees we've had in the past. I'm talking about the ones we have now.
They came from the same school.
The reason they were in the past.
Exactly.
Not to feel bad. It's quality control standards in place here in RWA for all his officiating, for his ring announcing, for his play-by-play announcing, for his security crew, for everybody, for his fans.
We have Piv to thank for the referees.
Okay. Piv to thank and Piv to blame.
The hammer taking it to Zubov. The fans, the river dirt, getting on him about it. Zubov coming back.
Oh.
Boot to the midsection. Snap suplex.
Don't know if you caught it. There was a little second of Zubov celebrating, and that may have been all that William Roberts needs. Just a little hesitation based on celebrating from Zubov.
Zubov should not have celebrated so early. Two count only by the hammer. Zubov still has a fight left in him, kicking back out.
Definitely a clear advantage right now by William Hammer Roberts. Let's see what he does with it. Let's see how he paces himself. Let's see how he manages this advantage.
The hammer slowly, methodically going after Zubov. It's what you expect from a big power man like him. Stepping on the back of Zubov, stepping on the back of the neck. He's worked on that for quite a while during this match, so sound strategy by the hammer.
Definitely. Just like any sports team, William Roberts, he's showing how he plays with a lead. Basically, he's showing what he does when he has the advantage. Does he let up? No, he does not.
Well, and one thing that we can say for certainty, if you've noticed, the hammer not really letting the river dirt here in West Newton get to him. They've been chanting everything at him. They've been saying things to him, and nothing. Off the ropes, and the hammer catches Zubov.
Oh, no. This is
throws him up on his shoulder, and down.
Wow, with power.
Up and down, one, two, and no. Two count only by the hammer on the Russian American Zubov. And once again, it's me alone. This is the way I roll. This is the way I work best. Shut up, Shelly. The hammer letting the crowd get to him here a little bit. They're chanting, you can't beat him, you can't beat him. So what is what does the hammer do? He takes him up on that challenge. Very reminiscent of the Iron Sheik's camel clutch, basically. Up and down on the small of the back of Zubov. The hammer just power, non-stop power.
5 minutes.
And once again, the Iron Sheik-like camel clutch on Zubov.
Sorry for stepping out. Once again, Dr. Feelbad with a quality control checkpoint on how you're doing. I told him everything was A-OK.
Well, I'm glad that you're telling him what's actually happening. Zubov. Reverse neck breaker on the hammer. Both men are down. Referee starting his 10 count.
You can definitely tell Zubov is a little worse for wear. All that working on that Roberts has done is getting to Zubov. He didn't have that move 100%. He got it done. He got the job done at the end of the day, but it wasn't as crisp as it could have been. You can tell Zubov is definitely getting tired. And that might be those aforementioned years and years of experience taking control.
Absolutely. The hammer and Zubov both back up. Zubov, right hand, ducking the hammer. A right, another right. Off the ropes. Russian American sickle. And the hammer goes down. Back elbow. Zubov on fire.
It's one thing Zubov could do. He knows how to manage his energy. When to turn it up, when to dial it down.
Bulldog and a beauty. Zubov up to the second rope.
He's taunting a little bit. I don't know if that's going to cost him or not.
For it and a beauty. Two count only. Zubov hitting the second rope. Russian sickle. Zubov looking like he wants to finish it off. He's going for the spear. He's calling for it.
This is his move.
The hammer, sidestep, side suplex, and a beauty on Zubov. Zubov down, hooking both legs. One, two, no. There's two count.
There's your swing advantage. Not only did Roberts get out of the way, but he was able to capitalize on that momentarily by doing a beautiful side slam on Zubov.
Absolutely, two count only, and you saw the hammer staring up into the ceiling here, wondering what he has got to do to finish Zubov off. He went for a clothesline. Zubov ducked it.
Not today.
The hammer showing the power, catching him. Zubov reversal.
And that's the experience of Zubov taking over. He was already in that move. He knows what to do, he knows how to react.
Zubov setting the hammer up again.
He is hell-bent on getting this move. He's hell-bent on getting this move in on Roberts.
This is the move that has won so many a match. And the hammer rolling outside of the ring.
Very smart move by the hammer. He's buying himself some time.
I think the hammer saw what was coming and didn't like it.
He's in a good position. The ring awareness is excellent by winning the hammer Roberts. He saw what he needed to do. He rolled out of the ring. He bought himself some time.
Smart maneuver. The hammer looks like he ain't getting back in the ring. 10 count. Count out. Zubov wins by count out, thanks to the hammer.
As the result of the count out, Zubov
winning by count out. That's like kissing your sister on New Year's Eve. It's a victory, but it's a cheap victory by Zubov. Bad. And if there's one thing I can say, it's about that time for Dr. Feelbad to come to the right side, which is my side. Feelbad, flat handing the river dirt here in West
Thank you.
as I'm aware of, even though he's never worked for my company, is anyone aware of Sheena Zion? Yeah. Or, of course, Zima Idol or TNA. What's wrong with the speakers, Hall of Hills?
I don't know.
Are you wondering like hot chocolate over there? What's wrong?
I'm fine. It might be that.
Okay.
That's what happens when you have a guy in a wheelchair going south.
Something very serious has happened where he had an emergency appendectomy and may even have a tumor in his intestines. It's not necessarily cancerous, so I'm not going to speculate that it is, but he has no medic insurance. Now, I know Sheena Zion personally, and like I said, even though he's never wrestled for this company, it's still a brotherhood, and he's an incredible athlete and needs to continue doing what he does best for you people, whether you watch him on TV or wherever you may see him. Over there at the ticket counter is a donation can, Sheena Zion Medical Fund. Even $1, $2 would be fantastic. And I'd also like to make the announcement that for this month's show, RWA itself will be donating $50. Thank you. And we will. And we will continue this as long as need be. Now, on to serious RWA business. I want to make sure that all of you hear me okay. Don't yawn. I'm not done. You might be pissed off what I'm about to say. Now, on to Mitchell and Edmonds. Mitchell and Edmonds, the cowards that they are, you have used the fact that Mitchell was injured recently and cannot perform in a steel cage. They legally have to refuse the steel cage. Because they're not under contract here. Now, one way or another, I promised you guys, I talked to you guys personally, a solution to the problem. I thought I could fight a legal battle, and by the end of the summer, put them in a steel cage somehow. Somehow bend their way. But if you bend their way, then they got RWA right by the balls. That's not happening. So how about Ryan Mitchell, Ryan Edmonds, you're fired. Go to hell. Don't come back. Go to
hell. Uh-oh.
I kind of expected the Ryans to come out hurting, Jack. I wonder what LODI's talking about here.
I don't think that announcement sat well with LODI at all.
I don't believe so. What's he going to say about it?
I personally don't like LODI, so I could care less.
You know he wants to get his hands on him, though.
LODI does not rule.
You can't deny this part, but you're hearing about students now.
champs.
This match off right.
He was going after me. I'm just the messenger. I'm just relaying what the referee did.
Well, you pissed him off is what you did.
Apparently, that's what I did. Everybody pissed Ryan Mitchell off today. lesson for LODI here is be sure to use last names.
LODI fighting back and smashing Ryan's face off of the steps. Ryan Mitchell and LODI fighting outside the ring off of a steel chair now. What the hell is going on here? Is this a non-sanctioned match?
I guess so. I mean, he wanted Ryan, he got Ryan. It wasn't the Ryan he wanted, but you know, you saw the pictures last night. You saw the RWA Live website.
Some
pictures they posted of what they did to LODI, both Ryan Mitchell and Ryan Edmonds in South Carolina last night. It was unbelievable.
It was unbelievable, but I didn't mind seeing it. Ryan Mitchell being taken around pillar to post, you could say, through the West Newton Arena. LODI beating Ryan Mitchell off of every corner. And you can hear the sound of that smack off the back.
LODI will not be denied in his anger. He will not be denied.
LODI wants revenge.
Ryan tried everything in his power.
And Ryan.
Clever move by Ryan Mitchell, like it or not, positioning the referee out of the way to be able to deliver the low blow on LODI.
Ryan Mitchell taking the low blow, taking the shot that needed to be taken to give him some rest, to give him a break from LODI's nonstop assault. Ryan Mitchell jumping out of the ring now, going after LODI.
I like it. Ryan Mitchell.
Oh my God, he's biting him.
Ryan Mitchell has a skill set that is unmatched here in the RWA. Absolutely unmatched.
Ryan Mitchell.
You couple that with his new attitude, his willingness to do anything to win, and you have a real dangerous man in the skill set brought to Ryan Mitchell.
Ryan Mitchell biting the head of LODI, now working over the back in the ring. Ryan Mitchell showing why he is one of the most talented people here in RWA
ever.
Going to a four count, breaking before five, completely legal. People may not like it, but it's legal.
He's a smart man who's wrestled all over the world and picked up his experience along the way. These are the things he has learned.
Break to the eyes. Ryan Mitchell showing one of the River Dirt here in West Newton that he thinks they're number one.
Or was it two? I don't know.
LODI off the ring, out of the corner, bouncing out, hurting his rib cage. Now Ryan with a rear chin lock, digging the knee into the back of LODI.
Just digging it in, really, really wrenching it in there on LODI. LODI having nowhere to go. Great positioning by Ryan Mitchell here.
LODI trying to get the River Dirt here in West Newton rallied behind him, trying to get some energy to fight back. Elbow to the gut, making the double. Knee to the midsection, and LODI is down.
LODI is down once again. Ryan Mitchell soaking in the adulation of this crowd. Used to be he did that, and all he heard were cheers. Today, a decidedly different story for the Steel City prodigy, Ryan Mitchell.
Absolutely. I've talked to Ryan Mitchell since this. Newfound, how can you say, hatred. And he said that since he started here in RWA, he has always hated the River Dirt. Now, he's just admitting to it.
You know, that's exactly it. You can have your true feelings about somebody, and he must have been a good actor all these years, because I thought for sure he loved them every bit as much as they loved him.
Corner with a side slam. LODI's down. Ryan Mitchell, cover two and no.
Excellent move. The playful momentum that he had when he picked LODI up there. Excellent move by Ryan Mitchell. Not quite enough, but he's well on his way.
Full mount by Ryan Mitchell. Fists, right fist going to the face of LODI.
Ryan Mitchell.
Ryan Mitchell can do whatever he wants to. And LODI is down. He's in a very compromised position right now.
Ryan Mitchell going to the top rope. We have seen this countless number of times from the Steel City Prodigy.
He's taking a lot of time up there. Taking a lot of time, is he? Oh, my God.
Maybe too much time.
A mistake by Ryan Mitchell. He had him where he wanted him. Stayed a little bit too long on that top rope. I know he's got a couple seconds, but a little bit too long. Should have been a lot faster. Big mistake by the Steel City Prodigy, Ryan Mitchell. And now it's time to see if LODI can capitalize.
Both men trying to get to their feet. Who will be up first? Looks like LODI is. Right hand from Mitchell and right from LODI. Back and forth. Here we go. Rope-a-dope. Southpaw LODI throwing those lefts. Back elbow. Clothesline. LODI on fire. LODI looks like he's going for it.
5 minutes going on. 5 minutes.
Boots to the midsection. LODI off the ropes and swinging neck breaker on Ryan Mitchell. 1, 2, and no.
Yeah, the thing we've noticed was LODI. When he gets fired up, he is in his zone unlike anybody else here in the RWA. You can't stop him. He gets in his own zone. It takes this game to a whole other level.
Wait a minute. Ryan Edmonds.
Oh, wow.
Back in the ring. Referee calling for the bell. Disqualification. Ryan Edmonds beating the ever-loving hell out of LODI. And now Ryan Mitchell joining in on the fray. These two have completely unfinished business with LODI.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has disqualified Ryan Mitchell because of Ryan Mitchell's interference.
And no! Double steel curtain, you could say. Double sit-out, choke slam, whatever you want to call it, the circle has decimated and taken LODI out. The circle standing tall in the ring. Taking LODI out of the equation completely here tonight. Damn it, this is the best commentary you'll ever hear.
Are we having fun? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Serafini.
And their opponents,
Shirley Feeney, I mean. Making their triumphant return here in RWA as the tag team champions. You got DC, Bentley, and the big star. DC and the big star, tag team champions here in RWA, joined by their manager, Sane. This ought to be one hell of a fight. These two, I know for a fact, have not wrestled here in RWA by themselves. Team against team, one-on-one, whatever you want to call it. They have not had this kind of contest before, so this ought to be interesting to see what kind of dichotomy these two have against each other. The A-list known for their party antics, for having a good time, but for getting the job done in the ring. Wild West virtual newcomers here in RWA showed up last month during the Tag Team Championship tournament and took home the gold. So we'll see if they can keep the gold here tonight. See if they can continue on as Tag Team Champions here in RWA. Or are we going to crown new champions here tonight? There's only one way to find out. That's for the zebra in the ring to ring the bell. And let's get this started. You'd think I had on cue, man. I did that perfect.
You got him well under your thumb, my friend. Well under your thumb. A great matchup for the RWA Tag Team titles. Two young and hungry teams.
Two young and hungry teams. And as I mentioned earlier, you weren't here for it. These two teams have never gone one-on-one before, so it'll be interesting to see what kind of strategy they employ against each other to see who can become the victor here tonight and become RWA Tag Team Champions or remain Tag Team Champions.
It'll also be very interesting in this particular match to see the role that their seconds play. They both have seconds. A-list having the lovely Serafini at ringside, and Wild West having their protection, same. Obviously two different people serving two different roles for their respective teams.
Well, Sane has proven himself worthy in the past. He definitely is a powerhouse outside the ring. Very unpredictable. Shirley Feeney, on the other hand, her and Laverne have gotten into wars in the past. Two bad shots, brewery closed down. She's going for manager.
A long memory, but she is attractive, and she might be a good diversionary tactic for them to use against the team of DC and the big star.
DC Bentley claiming a hair pull by Juice Jennings.
He lets you use their last name. They told me specifically today when I was announcing them, DC, big star, no last names. They go for the bright lights, they go for the nicknames, and that's it.
I'll try to remember that, but honestly, I do my own thing.
There you go.
If they don't like it, tough.
There you go.
DC claiming a pull of the hair once again by Juice Jennings. The referee doesn't seem like he's buying it. The River Dirt here in West Newton getting loud and letting DC and Big Star know what they think of him.
Definitely not shy to hold their opinion back on the people of West Newton.
Poke to the eye. DC is taking Juice down to a knee.
He kind of has to. There's a distinct size advantage between Juice Jennings and DC. DC is full fight, though, for someone his size.
It's never about the size of the fight and the dog. It's about the size of the dog and the fight, or vice versa, whichever you prefer. Shirley Feeney, being the rat she is, she pulled the legs of Big Star there.
Definitely some interesting tactics. Now, it takes two to tango, it takes two to maybe do what it takes to get the win. I was not expecting that from Sarah Feeney, but she did it anyway. I think she feels she knows what she needs to do to try to match up with these guys.
You need to correct it with Shirley Feeney.
There you go, there you go.
Joey Vengeance in the ring with a nice armbar, tagged in Juice Jennings. Juice Jennings off the second rope. Double axe handle, and now we're got it back on again. Tag once again, quick tags in and out between Juice Jennings and Joey Vengeance so far to start the match.
That's one hallmark of these two guys, the A-list. They've been together a long time. They know each other's strengths and weaknesses. They know how to compliment each other in that ring.
Joey Vengeance, Juice Jennings, working on the confusion factor on Big Star, didn't know what to do, got caught with the leg lariat. Tag in once again. Joey tags Juice. Double team. Juice setting up. Beautiful maneuver. One, two, and no. Two
great,
count only
great
on
Great dual
Big
maneuver
Star.
Showing what each of them could do. Juice is more of a powerhouse. Lifted him up. Joey's more of the aerial guy. Came up with a very high leg drop. Excellent double team maneuver by the A-list.
Absolutely. Double team maneuvers. Tag in and out again once again. Now, these two guys remind me of an old school tag team you might have heard of, the Rock and Roll Express.
That's right, they're a tag team to the extreme. These guys are great, they have it going on, they know what they're doing.
Sane standing here in front of us.
Excellent.
Man frightens me.
Very opposing presence, Sane is, very opposing. Definitely the right man for the job, for the Wild West.
Big Star in and out underneath the bottom rope, breaking the count.
You know, he's taking that timeout on his own. We talked about no timeouts in wrestling. You can make your own timeouts. Unless, of course, Juice Jennings does that to throw off your rhythm.
Rope it up around the ring, Big Star, and oh!
Oh, wow.
Juice
great
is
move.
Down by...
Great team awareness by the Wild West. Great team awareness. Same position up perfectly, positioned himself perfectly to lower the boom on Juice Jennings.
Sane, beautiful, double team now, triple team. Wild West with Sane taking Juice Jennings and beating him up a little bit outside the ring. Juice, hand on the rope.
5 minutes gone by. 5 minutes.
DC taking the bandana off and using it to choke Juice.
Any means necessary at this point in the match, any means. They're a tag team that got the belts through any means necessary, and they're willing to keep them by any means necessary.
Well, Wild West has one advantage, and that is the champion's advantage. They do not need to be, they do not need a pin or submission to keep the belts. They can win by count out, disqualification.
They can do whatever they need to do.
And they keep the titles.
It's a lot easier for the tag team champions to keep the belts than it is for the challengers to win.
Absolutely. Tag in from Big Star to DC. Leg drop and a beauty off the second rope onto Juice's, the back of Juice's head. One, two, and no.
Complete momentum shift now on the side of the Wild West. Great tag team maneuvers, great positioning. The three of them work very well as a unit.
DC did not have enough body on body in that pin, I think, was one of the reasons why he wasn't able to get the three count.
Arrogant, especially. You need every ounce of what you could do if you're a little guy like DC.
Oh, DC's definitely not a little guy. I mean, you look at him, he has some power to him. Juice Jennings, while he's a taller man, DC was still able to keep him down and keep him under control.
True.
Suckering Joey into the ring. Now we got a choke and stomp by DC and Big Star. Double team maneuvers. You know, in all honesty, these guys remind me of the Freebirds.
Exactly.
First off, you never knew who you were going to fight. Secondly, you just never knew where they were coming from.
Exactly. Great analogy. Great analogy. Three guys on the road who could do their thing in the ring. Sane is great protection outside of the ring. Great protection for Sane outside. And these two guys know how to get it done in the ring. But really, when you face the Wild West, you need to face and be mindful of all three guys.
As you saw right there, Sarin once again getting involved. Joey telling Sarin what he thinks of him. Juice off the ropes. Duck the clothesline. Double clothesline. Both men are down.
That could be the shift of my man, the A-list knee.
A-list. Juice trying to get over to Joey. Big Star comes in. Didn't get the tag, but he stopped Juice anyway. Referee looks like he's going to allow the no tag. Big Star, only a two count.
Well, six people to be watchful for in this match. I don't envy referee Jimmy James' position at all. He's trying the best he can. Maybe it's a case of him swallowing the whistle, so to speak.
Listen, I don't know what the hell's wrong with Jimmy James, but so be it, whatever. DC now beating up on Juice and behind the referee's back.
Again, another example of great positioning. They're able to get the referee's attention away from their corner into the corner of the A-list.
Back elbow by Juice. Kick to the face on DC. Juice coming back now. Double dropkick and a beauty.
One on two double dropkick. Great awareness by Juice Jennings. That could be the opening he needs to swing the tide of this match.
Juice trying to get over. Joey Vengeance, well, it looks like Sarin actually took Joey Vengeance off the ring apron. Big Star now attacking him from behind. We got a two-on-one mugging on Joey outside the ring. Referee is letting this go because it's a tag title match.
Sarin
knocked out the referee.
Falls off on the referee, Jimmy James. Unbelievable. Juice with the roll-up. Nobody to count.
Here comes another referee. One, two. No.
Referee Bo Brown is coming in to restore order in this match. Jimmy James is out cold.
Serafini just slapped Sarin, which is not a good idea. DC into Big Star. Juice now rolling DC over.
Of DC.
A-list punt. One, two, three. Oh my God. We have new RWA Tag Team Champions. Juice Jennings, Joey Vengeance. With Shirley Feeney. The A-list showing that they won the gold here tonight. Got something going on here. Jimmy James is over here talking to Bart. The championship advantage coming into play. Sarin, well, soon to be coming to the ring. There he is. He is a good friend of mine. Patrick Hayes. Patrick Hayes has become a real fan favorite. in RWA since his outspokenness toward the, as he put it, movie stars that gave up on RWA. Patrick Hayes getting a rousing ovation from the River Dirt here in West Newton. And now it's time.
Talked about promos in the history of this business. Patrick Hayes going off on some of the biggest stars due to their involvement in the Wrestlers vs. Zombies movie. It's almost like the battle between wrestling, traditional wrestling, and the showbiz aspect of what wrestling could be.
The River Dirt here in West Newton harassing Ryan Edmonds.
In other news, the Sun came up this morning.
And we got a circle crowd.
It's like a circle line, if that makes sense in terms of physics and geometry. It's a circle line.
We have the bell.
Match is underway. Patrick Hayes heard the bell, and he runs live.
Patrick Hayes attacking Ryan Edmonds from behind. Drop kick by Patrick Hayes on Ryan Edmonds.
We're joined, here we go.
He didn't even ring the bell yet.
And now, folks, I am joined by one half of the circle. I'm joined by simply the Steel City Prodigy, Ryan Mitchell. Ryan.
Close enough, dude.
I try.
Thanks for having me.
First of all, this is total garbage. This is total garbage because the bell didn't even ring and Hayes jumped him.
I wholeheartedly agree with you. The bell didn't ring. Patrick Hayes attacking from behind, taking Ryan Edmonds, kicking him while he's outside the ring before the match even started.
Absolute garbage, but we'll get him now. Now that it's back one-on-one, you'll see it.
Absolutely.
I wish some of the people in West Newton would wear a bra. I'm going to throw up sitting here with you. If I throw up on your equipment, I apologize.
I can understand why it would happen. Patrick Hayes.
Yes, sir. I tell you what you think about Ryan.
Patrick Hayes.
The glamour in this town is incredible. I think you should just buy a bra and sit down and watch the match.
Ryan Mitchell, live microphone. He will say whatever he wants to, folks. Ryan Edmonds in control of the match. Beautiful shoulder takedown by Ryan Edmonds.
Now we got him, now we got him. Oh, hey!
Patrick Hayes, back elbow, catching Ryan Edmonds off guard. Checking to see if a chipped tooth or anything. See absolutely nothing.
I think I may have saw a little more than I cared to see.
Ryan Edmonds taking a breather outside. Ryan Edmonds doing what Ryan Edmonds
did. Get a bra, I'm gonna talk to you until I can't see your shit hanging all over the place.
Ryan Edmonds doing what he does best, which is firing a crowd up. Ryan Mitchell doing what he does best with a live microphone. Back in the ring. Looks like we're going for a test of strength here.
Oh, well, obviously we got him. Edmonds outweighs him by 400 pounds.
And that's 400 pounds of muscle.
Absolutely. I mean, look at him. He's rippling. He's rippling. You can see the striations in his chest moving as he walks. He's a mammoth of a man. Perfection. Just like his partner. Hey!
Cheap move by Patrick Hayes. Boot to the midsection. Oh, no. No. Oh, God. 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 Patrick Hayes, without a doubt, throws the hardest chops in this business today. And unfortunately, Ryan Edmonds has felt them up close and personal. Ryan Edmonds just a little quick and a little smart, moving out of the way just in time. Patrick Hayes, LODI in the ring, LODI on the clock. Oh my God! LODI just beating the living hell out of Ryan Edmonds with a crutch. Chasing him down. What the hell? LODI beating the hell out of Ryan Edmonds. Ryan Mitchell beating the hell out of Patrick Hayes. Jesus God, I don't know what the hell's going on here. There is pure chaos. There is pandemonium. Ryan Mitchell telling the River Dart to get out of the way. Patrick Hayes beating the hell out of Ryan Mitchell now. Patrick Hayes telling people to move. Dear God!
into the tables, into the chairs. What the hell is going on here in RWA? This has turned into chaos. Ryan Mitchell with a chair hitting Patrick Hayes. LODI just beating the ever-loving hell out of Ryan Edmonds on the other side of the ring. I can't even see what the hell's going on over there.
We're safe over here. We're not safe, Church. We're not safe.
Telling you what, Bert, they come this way. You're all alone. I'm out of here.
Slingshot. Slingshot on Mitchell.
Oh, my God. Into the post.
Oh, my God. Hey, Ryan. Slingshot on Mitchell. Right into the ring post outside this ring. LODI's beating Edmonds with a clutch.
Ryan Mitchell face first into the pole. Ryan Edmonds and LODI back into the ring. LODI beating the ever-loving hell out of Ryan Edmonds. Oh my God!
This is what LODI wanted. Unsanctioned, no rules, just a free chance to beat the hell out of Ryan Edmonds and Ryan Mitchell. Patrick Hayes holding up his end of the bargain as well.
Patrick Hayes is just throwing chair after chair on Ryan Mitchell. Burying him basically in a sea of chairs out in the middle of the crowd. Ryan Mitchell back to his feet.
Here comes Hayes.
Ryan Mitchell holding his steel chair.
Good God.
God. Patrick Hayes. Chair shot. Chair shot from Mitchell to Hayes. Hayes into the corner. Hayes into the ring post now. Ryan Mitchell kicking chairs.
That's my drink.
So much for your drink.
It was.
Hope you didn't want the rest of it.
I don't think we can get the rest of it.
Ryan Edmonds. Oh, my God.
I'm
going
to take that up with Mitchell after the show, maybe.
I wouldn't recommend it. Oh, my God. LODI just used a crutch on a title belt on Ryan Edmonds' private parts. What the hell is going on here? Ryan Mitchell now in to try to help Ryan Edmonds. And Ryan Mitchell's now getting attacked by LODI.
That was the belt, by the way, that was given to a fan at intermission.
Ryan Mitchell, Ryan Edmonds getting the hell out of Dodge, and I don't blame them.
They have to somehow. This guy is stuck in the curtain now.
Ryan Edmonds, Ryan Mitchell, pure chaos. LODI, Patrick Hayes, standing tall in the ring. The circle has finally had it given to them. accompanied by Dr. Feelbad? What the hell is going on here?
Yeah.
just that damn good. And I can assure you, if you stand up doing this, I will slap you in the face like the bitch that you are.
Ashton Amherst pulling out his gun, giving us his thoughts. And I can't argue with him.
With a 60-minute time limit. And it's for the RWA Heavyweight Championship. Introducing the challenger, in the ring to my right. He weighs in at 222 pounds. He hails from the wrestling capital of the South, Atlanta, Georgia. Here is Ashton Amherst. And his opponent, weighing in at 225 pounds, and wrestling out of Altoona, Pennsylvania,
KATO! Ashton Amherst receiving a mixed reaction from the River Dirt here tonight in West Newton. KATO, however, the extreme fan favorite in this match. Ashton Amherst posting with the belt. The referee showing it off. That's what it's all about. The 25 pounds of gold. And the bell rings, and this match is underway. And Ashton Amherst already playing mind games.
Ashton Amherst back in a big way. He has a chip on his shoulder against everybody here in the RWA.
I don't blame him. He's been screwed over. These idiots have wanted him to be good. He did what they wanted, and they turned their backs on him. Nobody cared about Ashton Amherst when it came to the River Dirt here in West Newton, and he realized it, and that's why he's back tonight with a vengeance. KATO asking for the microphone.
Hey, Ashton Amherst.
Now that's not nice.
Did you come here to fight, or did you come here to be a pussy?
Such language from our RWA heavyweight champion. Is unapproachable at this point. Amherst throwing a chair down. Amherst highly upset.
He's also somebody, once he steps into that zone, he could channel that anger, he could channel that intensity like nobody else.
I will never forget the summer of the Ashton Amherst-Ryan Mitchell rivalry. They tore this house down every month.
Unbelievable.
Ashton Amherst feuding with some of the biggest names here in RWA. And now back once again to feud with the heavyweight champion, KATO.
KATO playing a game of one-upsmanship. Anything you could do, I could do better. In this case, throwing a chair.
I think KATO was just making fun of Ashton more so than playing one-upsmanship, but hey, it is what it is.
That's right.
All that matters at the end of the day is who's raised that 25 pounds of gold in their hand. KATO getting off some few chops onto Ashton, knocking him back into the corner. Open hand slap.
Definitely take advantage like only KATO can. Ashton fighting back.
And giving back a few chops of his own. This is a match of chops.
Unbelievable, unbelievable.
Referee trying to back KATO out of the corner. Let Ashton Amherst stand up. KATO now just wailing on Ashton Amherst in the corner.
No mercy at all.
Doesn't even care.
And if there's one person who knows how to use the champion's advantage, it is definitely KATO.
Absolutely. As you mentioned, the championship advantage, the champion has to be pinned or has to submit. If he gets disqualified or he gets counted out, so be it. He's still the champ.
That's right.
KATO shoulder block now, off the ropes, reversal. Went for a hip toss to Adden. KATO countered it with a clothesline. Up and down. Inverted atomic drop. And just for good measure, apparently a normal atomic drop.
You know, I'm not really sure how familiar KATO and Ashton Amherst are with each other, but you can tell that KATO has definitely done his homework and done his scouting nonetheless. Everything Ashton's done so far, KATO simply has an answer for until right now.
Well, I can tell you with utmost certainty here in RWA, this is the first time that these two have ever gone one-on-one. Now, other companies, I can't speak for that.
It don't matter.
Here in RWA, what matters is what happens here. And right now, we are witnessing a first, which is Ashton Amherst, Mr. Just That Good, Mr. Best in Pittsburgh, against KATO,
yes,
the RWA heavyweight champion.
To be sure. Trying to get him into that corner, maybe trying to work the leg a little bit. He's been working the leg a little bit now.
Ashton Amherst
trying to further the damage.
Wrapping that knee of KATO. I'm telling him how great you are.
Did you hear that, Will? Ashton Amherst is great, and he's the first one to tell you that.
He is great.
He is just that good. Now imagine being Dr. Feelbad here. Dr. Feelbad wants what's best for the fans. Dr. Feelbad and Ashton Amherst have a history that go way back.
It's all thanks to the Feelbad Five.
That's right. You heard what Ashton had to say earlier about Feelbad.
Ashton Amherst working over the leg and the knee of KATO in the corner, wrapping it around the steel post.
5 minutes going by. 5 minutes.
And now Ashton Amherst making fun of KATO. Mocking KATO. Mocking the fans, or correction, a river dirt here in West Newton.
KATO mocked Ashton Amherst. This is Ashton returning the favor.
Ashton working over the knee of KATO.
Once again.
Trying to dislocate it or something along those lines. But let's be honest, if you take out the knee, you take out the leg of KATO, KATO ain't standing up.
A lot of KATO's offense is standing up, but definitely if you do that, I mean, you can almost tell he's almost wrestling like kind of like the old school Anderson style. Take one body part and work it over, completely incapacitate that part, and then work the rest of the body from there.
Well, absolutely. Ashton Amherst being from the wrestling capital of the South, Atlanta, Georgia, you know that he had to grow up watching the Andersons, learning from the Andersons.
Right, you can't help but do that with your Ashton Amherst and where you come from, where he has come from.
Working it over now, single leg bust and crab. Kato can't stand. Kato can't do the Keystone Cross. He can't maneuver. That's one less thing that Kato can possibly do against Ashton Amherst.
That's a major weapon in Kato's arsenal. If he doesn't have that, Kato can still do a lot, but that's the biggest weapon that Kato has.
Ashton Amherst working over the leg, reminiscent, as you said, of the Andersons, but also reminiscent of one of the greatest world champions of all time, the Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Indeed, indeed. You can tell
snapping that over.
Studied and learned from the best.
Flipping over Kato, snapping the knee out of place. Referee not counting, Kato's shoulder wasn't down. Ashton Amherst doesn't look happy. The referee not doing his job, in my opinion.
Does Ashton Amherst ever look happy?
Absolutely. Have you seen him whenever he carries the belt around?
That's true, that's true. He needs that gold to be happy. He is obsessed over gold, obsessed over championships. When he does not have those championships, Ashton Amherst is an incomplete man.
Those championships prove what Ashton Amherst says every night, that he is just that good,
exactly.
And that he is the best in Pittsburgh. Kato kicking Ashton Amherst out to the floor. Ashton's down. Dr. Feelbad over there. Referee needs to watch him. Dr. Feelbad, I saw reaching earlier for the leg, trying to take out Ashton Amherst. Ashton back in, back elbow. Kato starting to get a second win.
Taking advantage of that extended relief he had when Ashton was out of the ring.
If you notice though, Kato favoring that left leg.
Severely, severely.
He's not able to even climb the turnbuckle.
Kato has to modify his offense. He is at a severe disadvantage with that leg, a severe disadvantage.
He's gonna have to modify his offense and modify his defense if he's gonna be able to survive this. Fists are illegal, referee. Kato walking around trying to get some feeling back into that knee and back into that leg. Beautiful maneuver.
That move took a lot out of Kato as well.
Kato still able to get him up, even bad leg and all. Two count only by Kato.
That's where you can tell the leg is a definite problem for Kato. It took him a while. Maybe that extra second it took him to get him over cost him in the fact there's a two count and not a three.
Ashton Amherst now fighting to get back to his feet. Kato tried to pick Ashton up, couldn't do it. The knee kind of gave out on him. Ashton whipping Kato into the corner. Knee to the face, followed by a bulldog and a beauty. We've seen a lot of people put away by just this itself. Two count only, says the referee. I swear this referee can't count.
You know one thing about Kato, he's not only fighting for his RWA title, which we both know he holds dearly, he's fighting for a lot of pride. There's a lot of pride right now in Kato. He said some very big words at the end of last month's show. And he's been under a firestorm of controversy to try to keep up with those words and try to live up to those words ever since. Message boards, commentaries, Facebook have been all on Kato. Kato has the weight of the world on his shoulder, so to speak. He's fighting for the RWA. He's not fighting for the title, he's fighting for the company.
Kato's fighting maybe for the company, but I say he's fighting for his own ego. Regardless, Kato down, Ashton Amherst up on the top. Referee distracting him. Kato's getting back to his feet. This isn't good for Ashton. Ashton, watch out.
You can tell Ashton was distracted by the fans a little bit. They crossed him. He looked over, glanced over for maybe 1-2 seconds. And that's all the time that Kato needed to get into position to cost Ashton with that move.
Kato falling into the ropes, knocking Ashton off of the ring.
10 minutes gone. 10 minutes.
Now Kato climbing the ropes. Will that knee give out or will it hold? That's the question right now. Kato looking like he's going for a superplex. Ashton Amherst blocked it, reversed it. Forearm shot to the side of the head. Dear God, you heard that all the way in Butler. Kato throwing Ashton Amherst off the top rope.
And you gotta wonder who got more hurt by that move. It wasn't quite the effect Kato wanted because his knee does not have the strength to support his body to support that move.
Kato's knee completely destroyed. I don't think he's gonna be able to get up onto his feet again.
Not at all, not at all. It's been very tough for Kato. Kato's a very much an uphill battle right now to fight.
I stand corrected. Kato and Ashton Amherst both to their feet.
That's that adrenaline kick again.
Trading right hands.
They both believe for what they're fighting. They fight for what they believe in. And you can see it right here. They're both weary. They're weak. And they're doing what they can, trying to beat the other one.
Flip of a reversal. One, two, and three. What? Suplexing the referee.
Gentlemen, the winner is the RWA Heavyweight Champion. It's KATO.
Ashton Amherst. Ashton Amherst now beating up Burt LeGrand, of all people. Ashton Amherst beating up the ring announcer, kicked Kato, took out the referee, and now kicking Fieldman between the legs, hitting him in the side of the head with the RWA Heavyweight title. If the winner is a determination on who's standing and who's not, in my eyes, Ashton Amherst is your winner. Ashton Amherst declaring he is the RWA Heavyweight Champion, declaring that he won that match. Kato down. Feelbad down. Burt LeGrand down. Referee down. Hell, everybody's down.
Yes.
But me.
I'm under no obligation to fight you again. But unlike these trailer track girls think, I ain't scared. And unlike them, I ain't got the hurt. But I'll tell you this much, you gonna come back next month? Who wants to see me kick his ass?
this has been one hell of a show. I'm losing my voice, but as always, I am your only wrestling reverend, Church. The commissioner's gone. Now my commentating partner's gone. Nobody, and I mean nobody, has been here as long as me. And you will have me every month. I am your one and only wrestling reverend, Church, and I'm getting the hell out of here.